Hello, YouTube. So I do a quick video here. I've been asked to email about how to set up a solar power GMRS to array repeater. So we're going to do a video series on this. The part one that I'm doing now is going to be about calculations, how big a battery we need, how much current we're going to be drawing, all that good stuff. So this video is going to be about that. And then part two, we'll do maybe some like the panel. How big of a solar panel do you need, and all that stuff. But this is going to be part one. So I also want to mention, I am no solar expert by any means. So if anyone out there is a solar expert, does solar panel installation for a living, please make a comment below. Maybe there's a better way of doing this, how I'm going to do this now. I'm being upfront, and I'm just telling you that now. I will be getting a solar panel and doing this, and I'll make videos of me actually doing this, and we're going to get some real numbers, some real information, because I'll have it here and I can measure voltages. I can tell you all the good stuff. But that won't be until, I don't know, maybe summertime. We'll see. I was hoping to do it this summer, but you know how that goes. So I just want to make that clear that I'm no expert at this. So another thing too, I want to also mention now, is that if you're going to do a solar setup, there's four things that you should kind of think about. And the first thing is, do you really need 50 watts? Okay? And the reason being is, if you have a 50-watt repeater, that's going to require, obviously, a lot more power to power it. You're going to need bigger batteries. You're going to need a solar panel that can keep up. That's going to cost you more money. Now, again, higher wattage gives you penetration, does not really give you distance. I've done a video on that showing that proof. Penetration help with leaves and branches and sticks and whatnot and whatever. But just keep that in mind. If you can get away with a 15-watt repeater, 25-watt repeater, you're better off. It won't cost you as much when getting batteries, solar panels, and all that stuff. Okay? So I keep that in mind. The second thing that's important is what type of setup you're going to be doing here. Is this going to be a battery backup type of setup? That the only time this repeater is going to be running is when the power actually fails. You got electricity at your location and the power fails, and you need something to keep things going. So if that's the case, then you don't need as big of a setup, because you won't be running it constantly just for battery backup. The other thing you want to kind of keep in mind is this going to be a temporary setup? And what I mean by that is, let's say you're going to go hunting with some buddies and you need a repeater because you're going to be out in the woods. You're going to put the repeater on a small hill, and he's going to be on one side of the hill in the valley, and you're going to be on the other side of the hill in the valley, and you just need to communicate, a couple miles at the most, if that. Well, one, and it's going to be temporary, you're going to take it down after a couple days. It's not going to stay up there. So, good case in point, you sure don't need a 50-watt repeater to do that. Secondly, we don't need all the solar panels and all that stuff, because you can bring the battery with you when you're done for the day and charge it at the cabin, and then when you go out the next morning, just hook the battery back up. And you won't need as big a battery, because if you're only going to be running a repeater, you're not going to be running any accessories like a Raspberry Pi or a mini PC or you're not, you're just using the repeater, then your battery, usage size can even be smaller, and that makes it more cheaper in the long run. So those are the most important things you got to decide right now before you do any of this. How much wattage do you really need your repeater to do? Where is there going to, is this going to be a battery backup only type of system? Or is this going to be my full power? This is how I'm going to power the actual repeater. Is it going to be temporary? And actually, I guess you'd add the fourth one in. Do I need internet? Because that, you know, the less accessories that you don't need, the better off. So that's, you got to keep all that in mind. So any rate, so once you decide what size repeater wattage wise you need, you're going to gather all your items up, whether you're going to run accessories, whether you're not going to run accessories, whatever the case may be. You need to gather up your items. We got to look at some amperage usage that these items use. Now, if you plug these into wall outlets, or there's a wall outlet adapter, that adapter is going to tell you the rating that is required for that particular device. A lot of times these wall outlets, they rate them higher than what they actually need. But we want to do the maximum. Again, we're going to be calculating the maximum load that I'm doing in this video. Now, you and I both know, unless your repeater is the Chicago Police Department, you're not going to be running, you know, 24 hours heavy usage. Okay? So my point is, if your repeater usage is not constant, a heavy load, there's some give in these numbers. And I'm going to show you that as we go on to give you examples. So we're going to calculate for the maximum. We need to know what the maximum power requirements are going to be for this. So you're going to grab all your adapters, whether it's a Raspberry Pi, whether it's a mini PC, whatever the case is, you're going to be running with your repeater, the repeater itself, all that. Look at the wall wart. And this one right here, this wall wart, we're going to look at the output. Right there is the output. We're going to write this down on a piece of paper. Let's just say this is a Raspberry Pi or whatever. It don't matter. This is just a picture I got off the internet. But you get my point. Write this down on a piece of paper. It's 12 volt, 1 amp. And then write down, a lot of times they tell you the configuration on the plug. Because you're going to need to know this. Well, you don't need to know, but it's going to be helpful. I'll get to that in a minute. So this one right here, the center is the positive, the outer is the negative. Okay? So we're going to write all this down on a piece of paper. So when you get done, it should look like this. Now, like I said, I'm going to be using the Redivis RT97S repeater for many reasons. Obviously, I already have that, and I want to hook up internet and all that to it. And secondly, it doesn't take a lot of power. It's only 6 watts output. That's all I need for what I'm going to use it for. I don't need any more wattage. So that's why I'm picking this repeater, and like I said, I also already have it. And that repeater, the wall adapter that you plug in for that repeater, if I remember correctly, I believe it was 2 amp. I don't have it in front of me, but double check that just to make sure I'm correct on that. And it's 12 volt, that I do know. My interface board is 1 amp, 12 volt. Now, I can tell you right now, my interface board does not take 1 amp. But we're doing it maximum, what the wall adapter is rated for, so that you have, you'd rather be higher, a little too high than too low in your calculations. My mini PC that I did a video on the other day is 3 amps at 12 volt power. That's what it says on the wall adapter. Double check what you're going to use, whether it's a Raspberry Pi, whether it's going to be mini PC. You need to check the amperage and the voltage. Okay, I'm going to tell you why here. You need to know both. This is going to help. This is going to help you save some money if you do it this way. Now, this is going to be kind of interesting. The cellular mobile hotspot. I don't have one here, but I did some looking online, and it looks like the hotspots have built-in batteries. And that's not a big deal, but we don't want to use the built-in battery because we want to hook this up directly to our big battery, our solar power battery. So we need to find out what the charger is on that. And I'm going to go with, for an example, but you double check, it's 1 amp at 5 volts. Now, I want to mention too that I know when you plug in a charger for any battery charging device, they don't always like you leaving it plugged in 24/7 because it weakens the battery. The battery won't hold a good charge over time. But truth be told, I don't care because I'm plugging into a better battery anyways. So I don't care if that's going to damage the battery inside. You know, just make sure that it doesn't overcharge that battery that's inside there. So you may have to email the manufacturer who makes your mobile hotspot to see if you can leave the battery charger plugged in 24/7. Tell them why, and they should be able to answer that. But double check that. You don't want to overcharge the battery that's inside the mobile device hotspot. So keep that in mind. So in my case, we're going to say we can leave the charger plugged in. It's not a big deal. So I'm going to go with 1 amp, 5 volts. Okay. All this equals 7 amps. But to be safe, I'm going to say 8 amps. Now, this is where it gets very important that you got to pay attention. This could really help save on cost and save on battery size and all that. Now, if you haven't noticed, these three right here are 12 volt. I don't need to plug those into an AC inverter. So that's even better yet, because I don't need such a big AC inverter. I can get a small one to plug in my cellular mobile hotspot into it. These I can hook direct to the 12 volt battery, of course, through a fuse. And we'll get into the hardware in another video. But the point being is we can hook these up direct to the battery. That means I don't need more expensive inverter. I can use a smaller inverter, and life is good. But this one here, I cannot do that with. Do not hook up anything that is not 12 volts DC direct to a battery. If I was to hook up this 5 volt direct to the battery, it's going to ruin the mobile hotspot, obviously. So I got to plug this into an AC inverter. Not a big deal. I'm going to show you some AC inverters here in a minute. But my calculations that I'm showing you here does not include the AC inverter as a load, because an AC inverter does have a load on the battery. Mine is only going by what I'm doing here. And I'm said 7 amps. I'm going to go 8 amps because I got to plug in a AC inverter to power my hotspot. Okay, so we're going to go with 8 amps. Now, again, this is maximum power. It's like me going out there and dead keying my repeater and keeping it keyed up. And I got the interface board hooked up. I got the mini PC running maximum power. These are maximum numbers. We got wiggle room, quite a bit of wiggle room on this, but we'll get to that too. But I just want you to keep in mind. So we're going to say 8 amps. So now we're going to go, let me show you the inverters. And if you don't know what an inverter is, it is a device where you can plug in household appliances and hook it to your cigarette lighter or a 12 volt battery. Now remember, I don't need a big inverter because I'm only going to be powering this little hotspot. because I can't hook it direct to the battery. So I can go with this one right here, this $14 one that's 100 watt. It's pretty small. So that's all I need. Now, if you need a bigger inverter, because you got to plug in a lot more, then you're going to need a bigger inverter that's got more wattage. Like this one right here. What's this one? This one's 1,500 watts, $31. But it's bigger. And then you can plug in more items into it. You can plug in your, if your repeater does not do 12 volts, let's say your repeater has 19 volts coming out of your, out of the wall adapter or something. Or your repeater doesn't have, it's an actual repeater that plugs right into 120. There's no wall adapter. So you got to plug it into electricity. Well, you're going to need a bigger, it'll say how many watts that thing takes on the back of the ID tag. And it might say it needs, you know, I don't know, 100 watts. Well, then you got to do the watt calculations to see how big of an inverter you need. So keep that in mind. I don't need to do that because half of my stuff, more than half, I can plug direct into the battery. So that means cheaper inverter, smaller inverter, less room. So that's, you know, keep that in mind. So we're going to go with 8 amp, like I said. So this is the, you might be able to find these inverters cheaper elsewhere. I'm just picking Walmart's website. So now we got to figure out, we got to calculate, if we're going to go with my numbers, for my example, 8 amps, how big of a battery do I need? So we got to go to, this, I'll post the website links to this in the description below. So now we're going to enter in 8 amp. Make sure it's amps, not watts. You can use it to calculate wattage too if you needed to for your inverter. Battery type, lead acid. We're going to go with that. Yeah, there's different batteries. I'll kind of touch that a little bit. Duration. How many hours do I want this battery to run? Or how many hours do I want the load of 8 amps to run? Now remember, maximum load, 8 amps straight. No, when I say 8 amps straight, I mean there's no you know, standby. It's your max. This is maximum now I'm talking about. And I'm going to put down 8. I could probably put less because you and I both know I'm not going to be running 8 amps, you know, every second, every minute for 8 hours straight, because that means I'm going to have to dead key my repeater and have everything maxed out. Well, that ain't going to be, you know, obviously that's not going to happen. But I'm going to go with 8 hours. You can adjust to accordingly. Now, here's the part that you want to really pay attention to. Remaining charge on the battery. Now, don't just put 100% there, because 100% does mean the battery's fully charged. Well, in reality, nothing's 100%. So you put maybe put now 90%. However, this is very important. If you live in a cold in climate, do not put down 90%, because that's not going to be right. I live in Wisconsin. It can get as low as minus 40 degrees out with the wind chill. So I'm going, and cold weather dramatically affects the battery's capability to store the charge. The battery gets weaker when it gets colder. So I'm going to go with 60%. That's one reason why. The other reason why is I'm going to use a lead acid battery, and we don't want that battery to go below 50%, or we're going to shorten the life of that battery and how many times it can be charged and recharged and, you know, all that stuff. So you don't want to go less than 50%. So I'm going to pick 60. I could probably do 70, and that would be okay too, because I got to account cold weather now. Okay, and all what I'm saying here is, it, obviously it's on the page here. You can read it right here, okay? So you can read it if you forget. So I'm going to go with that. We're going to 8 amps, lead acid, 860. We're going to hit calculate. Now, this is going to tell me what size battery I'm going to need to do the 8 amps straight for 8 hours. Again, I'm emphasizing that. 160 amp hour battery. Now, in reality, I can probably cut that down to half because I'm not going to be, like I said, we're not going to be dead keying my repeater here. But we'll go with, let's just go with 160 amp hour. Let's just go with that number. I mean, it's I'm really, you know, on a really upper end on that, but let's go with that. So that's the amp hour battery I'm going to need. So let's go shop for some batteries. Now, I know people say you should use a deep cycle battery. They're meant to be recharged and discharged and recharged and discharged. Okay, that's true. But let's be honest here. If you're going to use this for a temporary location at your cabin, you don't need to go buy a deep cycle battery. You can use a regular lead-acid battery. You're going to be bringing it in, charging it at your cabin, like I was talking about earlier, or even hook it to a small solar panel. It's going to be fine. So, anyway, let's go ahead and go shopping for. Let's see what deep cycle batteries. Let's do what people tell us we should do. And technically, it is a better battery for this. So let's go shopping for deep cycle batteries. Okay, now. What do we got here? 12 volt. Okay, $40. What is that one? Okay, that's 12 volt, only 18 hour amp hour. So what would that? So let's enter that in there. There's a website that we can enter in the battery amp hours, how much current draw we're going to need, and it'll tell us how long it's going to run. So let's go to that website. This website, I guess, also has battery size too, but Either one you can. I'll post all these links in the description below. So we're going to go with 18 hour. There's a $40 battery. It's a deep cycle. 12 volt. So we're going to go with that. It's 40 bucks, but it's only 18 amp hour. So let's go back to here. Let's type in 18. And we're going to recalculate. We're going to make this back to 8 amps. And we're going to lead acid. We're going to hit submit. 1.6 hours at a constant 8 amp draw. So, in reality, I could probably cut this down. Let's say the repeater's half busy. We'll go with that. Let's make this be 4 amps because it's not constantly drawing the 8 amp load. Let's hit submit. Now I get to 3 hours. So keep this in mind with these calculations. We're going to go back to 8. And there's a reason why I'm doing this. And I'll show you in a minute. We're going to hit submit. 1.6 hours. That's for a deep cycle battery. So, which is, you know, we could, you know, like I said, we can get, you know, a few more hours if, you know, did 4 amp. Or if it's not constantly being under maximum load. Let's scroll through these deep cycles. I mean, these prices, look at this. $270, really? $270 for a battery? I mean, yeah, I know it's, oh no, well, it's renewable energy. 100 amp hour. Okay, let's enter in, let's see, I'm going to go buy a 279 battery. Let's see how much run time will I get at 8 amps. 8.9. Okay, that's almost a full day. All right. So, okay. So, but that's a $270 battery, though. I'll bet you I can get eight. I can probably find a battery a lot cheaper that can give me my 8 hours. Just won't be a deep cycle. So, but you kind of get my point here. So, if you have to have a 50-watt repeater and you got to plug it into an inverter, and you got to plug in all your accessories into inverters, and this is your main power for your repeater, you're probably going to need a good size battery. Well, here you go. Here is a solar power battery, deep cycle, 200 amp hour, 12 volt. Look at the price. Maybe you can get cheaper elsewhere. Let's enter that in. Let's go to 200 amp hour. Let's see what that's going to do. Obviously, it's going to probably do about 16 hours because if the one was, you know, okay, I was close. 17 hours. So ask yourself, do you really need a $450 battery? I mean, we're going to have some charging time in there with the solar panel too here, so just keep that in mind. We're going to do it the cheap way. I know some of the solar experts are going to be on that keyboard just a pounding away. Oh, you don't be doing that. Well, we're going to do it anyways. We're going to go to lead acid car batteries. We're going to go to riding lawnmower batteries. This is what we're going to do. This is how I'm going to do it. So, yeah, my battery may not last as long. I may shorten the life of my battery. But, come on, $500 for a battery? So, again, there might be cheaper ones out there. I'm just going by Walmart's website. So, let's pick. Okay, here's one. Let's put this one. This is a riding lawnmower battery. 230 cold cranking amps. Wow, that battery might work. But you're probably thinking, well, wait a minute, it's cold. We need amp hour. No problem. There's a conversion for that. This conversion is you divide cold cranking amps by 7.2. This is a rule of thumb. This is not like set in stone. It's, you know, it's a rule of thumb. So let's go back to my cheap battery, 230. So let's type in 230 divided by 7.25. That's going to give me 31 amp hour. Let's go back to the runtime calculator. Type in 31. And see what that gives me. Okay, 2.7 hours at an 8 amp constant load. I can do it for 2 hours straight. Well, again, we're not going to be, you know, that's maximum. So even if I cut that down, let's cut the amps down to 4, because it's, we're going to have, you know, times where it's not going to be 5.5 hours. So, okay, so that's not bad. Let's go back to 8. You kind of get what I'm doing here. I'm trying to, you kind of see, we got to shop. We got to do some shopping. We got to do some math here. We got to figure this out, because I mean, deep cycle, holy Jesus. I mean, you know, I'm sure there's cheaper ones out there, but this right here. Here's a deep cycle again, only 8 amp hours for $24. I mean, I know deep cycles are more expensive batteries, but wow. Okay, so anyway, so let's scroll through here. This was $230. What else we got here? Let's scroll down. Whoa. $275 for $34. So $275 is not a big difference from $230, but let's calculate it anyways for the sake of the video. $37. So let's go back to $37. Again, I got 8 amp maximum draw, 3.3. So, honestly, when I build mine, I'm going to go with this type of battery here. I'm going to go with this. That's what I'm going to do. Something similar. I don't know if it'll be on sale by the time I do it. You know, I might shop around a little bit more. But you kind of get where I'm going with this. So, sit down and really calculate. I mean, if you're doing this for, you know, your life-saving ambulance service, you know, type of situation, that's totally different, obviously. But keep in mind, you can shop around for, you know, batteries. That one's actually cheaper but less cold cranking amps. So that's look at this one, $340 for $50. Let's calculate. I think you're kind of getting the idea by now, but we're just going to show you here. And that's going to be 46. So let's go to runtime. Again, I'm using maximum current here, which is not going to be the case. We both know that, but 4 hours, that's $50. So you kind of get where I'm getting at here. What we have to do to get an idea what we're going to need here for a battery size. We need to know what battery we're going to go with before we start shopping for solar panels. So this is the first step. And then, like I said, the next video, I'll talk about different solar panels, hardware. Obviously, if you're going to be hooking up if you're going to be hooking up these directly to the battery, we're going to use a fuse block assembly. It's like $3-4. And each one has a separate fuse. It's kind of a neat little fuse block. We're going to be using that. So the next one's going to be solar panel and hardware that you're going to need. Obviously, you're going to need wire and all that good stuff. But that's probably the next video we're going to be touching on. I think you kind of get an idea what has to be done here to, you know, get the information to kind of calculate your battery. But just remember, when you get the numbers off your wall adapters, your repeater, that's maximum. That means that repeater is being keyed up, and it's being keyed up, you know, and that's the maximum. And a lot of times, those numbers on the back of the repeater, the wall wart, whatever you want to call it, they're going to be higher numbers because you want your power supply to be more than what your actual current draw is. So keep that in mind too. These numbers I got here are actually higher than what the unit actually draws. If I was to hook all this up and hook it up to a current, an amp meter, I could probably tell you it's not going to be drawing no 8 amps. I'm going to say, and realistically, since they overrate their power supplies, which that's what you should do, maybe 3-4 amps, maybe. I'm you know, that's even pushing it, I think. Maybe I'll get my current meter out and I'll hook all this up. What I have here, except for the hotspot, I don't have the hotspot, but I'll hook up everything else and see what it actually draws under usage with Zello and all that. So at any rate, I hope this gives you an idea. If you have any questions or comments, please post them down below. Please subscribe. Thank you and have a good day.